My physics sim expander will unlock new options for people who enjoy making simulations in Blender. It allows you to do some unique things and offers several utilities that can help to save a lot of time. A feature I'm most excited about is the ability to detect a particle's death and make use of that to create secondary explosions. Oh yes, you can now slam particles into your target and have a second emitter placed and ready to go at the moment of that particle's demise. Don't like when they go off? Redo it with a new offset setting to dial it back a few frames or delay them for a time. Another feature of my physics sim expander is that you can convert particles to actual rigid bodies. Tell the add-on what frame you'd like to let Blender's physics sim take over, and it will create keyframes for all particles up until that moment. But not all at once, because that would be stupid. It's based on each particle's individual birth time. So everybody flies for as long as you tell them to, then they go kamikaze. We can also use death as the trigger for becoming a rigid body and offset based on that, like in the previous feature. I'm having a lot of fun with this, and I think some of you will too. It allows for some very unique destruction. You can also make use of physical forces like wind or turbulence to guide them and then let them go at your target. Heck, you can even use voids if you want and they'll swarm at a target. If you're all out of things to destroy but still have that appetite for destruction, I've also included a simple plank or box tower creator. It tracks an empty as it builds, allowing you to build on top or place it in another spot for a new tower. After each build, they're automatically separated into individual objects with the correct origin. Use the divisor to make them as tiny as you want, or use the empty to put them wherever you want. Destruction without any structure can be pretty boring. How about automatic constraint generation? Oh yes, we can do that. We can do it so fast that it actually takes longer to delete them if you don't like the settings. If accuracy is important, you can use accurate mode to analyze the mesh and make sure that the closest points are connected. Use the chain tool to clone an object in a line, then use the master controller to rotate the entire formation. You can attach a big ball if you like, and now we have a wrecking ball to slam into those towers. The add-on also includes several functions that are massive time savers when doing your own simulations. Add rigid bodies to a bunch of objects and set weight with a single click. Use the same button to tweak the weight. Clone an object at the location of all selected objects and parent them as well if you want. Offset position, rotation, or scale and use the added rigid body animation, flip fluids inflow, or manta flow inflow to offset when your simulation objects start. We can even do particle system start and end offsets. I have many other ideas and plan to add even more customization settings to the add-on, which is available on Blender Market.